Snake, I wanted to ask you about the man on fire. What do you remember from the hospital? Anything we can use?
Well, he took off the moment the sprinklers started up.
Sprinklers? The fire system?
And when he got sprayed with water from the burst pipe, it slowed him down.
When we escaped on horseback, he wouldn't cross the river either.
And then it started to rain. And he disappeared.
Water against fire. Is it that simple? I mean, it makes sense. It's just hard to believe it would work on a guy like that. You mentioned that the man on fire was crushed under Sahelanthropus in its hangar.
Yeah. He was caught under the wheels of its transport platform.
But his body wasn't found.
What?
We searched the area the moment we arrived, but there was no trace of him.
I wasn't hallucinating.
I know. I trust you on that. That means someone must have taken the body. But when I got there, everything was still as it was. Even Skullface hadn't been touched. I can't see a reason to sneak into a place like that and drag out the biggest, heaviest guy there.
What are you getting at?
The only option left is... he got up and walked away.
That platform ran him over.
Just ran him over.
You're saying that's not enough?
I don't want to believe it, but maybe not. He shrugs off bullets, even rocket strikes. There's no reason to think that would finish him. It seems ridiculous, but I'll start gathering eyewitness accounts just in case.
If you dig up anything concrete, I want to know.
You'll be the first, if I dig anything up. But I hope to hell I don't.
No kidding.
Volgan, the GRU colonel, was burned alive with the Shagohod during Operation Snake Eater 20 years ago. Despite suffering severe burns to his entire body, he still clung to life. After you left Seleniarsk, Volgan's body was taken to a research institute in the outskirts of Moscow. But modern medicine couldn't explain why he was still alive. Not that the colonel was any ordinary man to begin with. That constant electric current he had running through his body that he could unleash at will. To be honest, I was always uncomfortable around him. Thought I might get electrocuted just by standing nearby. The Institute studying him was tasked with investigating and developing human paranormal abilities. The comatose Volgan was used to further the Soviet Union's research into such abilities. But not long ago, the facility burned to the ground. And Volgan's body was never found among the rubble, even though the fire started in the room where they were keeping him. This occurred at around the same time you woke up. If Skullface was right, and a thirst for revenge can turn a man into a demon and keep the dead alive, and this man on fire who's been coming after us ever since you woke up, well, that just might be what's left of our old friend Volgan. It's not over yet. Back in 64, in Seleniarsk, you brought his plans for a utopia down in flames. That grudge is what's keeping him alive. The day the research facility holding Volgan burned down, a Soviet jumbo passenger jet happened to crash nearby, far away to the north of that hospital in Cyprus. On board the plane was a young boy who was being studied at the same facility. The plane fell to Earth from over 8,000 feet, but the boy's body was the only one not recovered. At almost exactly the same time as the crash, Volgan awoke in that facility. According to the Research Institute's documents, the gifts this boy demonstrated included psychokinesis and telepathy. To protect his mind from being inundated with other people's thoughts, he always wore a kind of gas mask. A rudimentary form of psychic insulation, apparently. We don't know where this boy is, but if Skullface is connected to him, we may cross paths with him yet. This boy is part of a new age where nothing we understand about the world makes sense anymore. Don't let your guard down.